Breakfast is gonna be so... Regina, what did you do to Grandma's kitchen?
Well, I'm starting a new how-to channel. I just need somewhere to do my crafts.
And isn't that her favorite glitter?
I know, but it's just so shiny.
And aren't you...
Allergic.
Now, I'm gonna have to teach you how to clean all this up. Boys and girls, we are so excited for our brand new series called How To, where we talk about how Jesus taught us how to live. And we're gonna be doing all sorts of fun how-to projects, so we hope you'll join us every week. And speaking of every week, if you're new, we send out mail to all our friends every week. So text in your name and the word new to the number on the screen, and we'll start sending you our free mailers. We send out color sheets, prizes, maybe even some how-to supplies, letters. It's amazing, and you're gonna wanna be on that list. So all you gotta do is text in your name and the word new to the number on the screen. Regina. Boys and girls, we hope you join us for our brand new series, How To. Bye!
Hi, boys and girls, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Regina Rejoice. Can you say that with me? Regina Rejoice. Good job, boys and girls, and I'm a YouTuber. Do you know what a YouTuber is? That's right, we post our entire lives online. Good job, boys and girls, and I'm here for our brand new series called How To, because I'm a how-to YouTuber, and I teach you how to do stuff. Hi, boys and girls, my name is Miss Chastity, and whether you're joining us in person or online, we're so excited that you're here for our brand new series, How To, where we're gonna teach you how to live like Jesus. I know, cause I just told them that. Oh, Regina, you scared me. The only thing scary is low subscribers. Speaking of which, I gotta go check mine. Bye! Regina, where are you going? We still have to do the big idea, boys and girls. Do you wanna help me? Okay, on the count of three. One, two, three. Wow, boys and girls. It says Jesus taught us how to make a difference. Amazing, boys and girls. Now before we get any further, let's pray. Dear Jesus, thank you so much for new ways to learn about you. We are so grateful that you love us so much, and we can't wait to learn how to love you more. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Good job, boys and girls. Let's get to our worship song.
Seek, confess your faith in Jesus, our Savior.
Welcome back, boys and girls. Now, our Bible story today is something that Jesus said about salt and light. Now, I know what you're thinking. Jesus wasn't opening a salt lamp store. That would be so silly. No, Jesus wants us to make a difference in the world, and he used stories or parables to help us do that. So let's read in our Bible. We're in Matthew 5:13, and it says, "You are the salt of the earth. But if the salt loses its saltiness, how can it be made salty again? It is no longer good for anything except to be thrown out and trampled underfoot." Boys and girls, that says that we're the salt of the earth. I don't taste very salty. Let's watch this video and we'll learn a little bit more about that.
It's time for today's Bible story. It comes from the book of Matthew chapter 5. When Jesus began to teach people about God, sometimes he would tell stories to give examples. He would start talking about one thing to explain another. One day, Jesus was teaching his followers how to make a difference in the world. So he talked to them about salt. In Matthew 5:13, Jesus said, "You are the salt of the earth." Seems like a pretty weird thing to talk about, right? Until Jesus brought up what salt does. It gives flavor to food that doesn't taste very good or doesn't have that much taste to it at all. If you eat food without salt, you might say, "Ugh, yuck." But when you salt the food, you might say, "Yum, it tastes really good." When we go out and make a difference, we do the same for the world. Turn it from yuck to yum. Like when someone falls down and you help them back up, or when someone says something mean and you stick up for them, or say something nice to them. That's like sprinkling salt on something otherwise yucky. Jesus also taught that making a difference was like shining a light. In Matthew 5:14, Jesus said, "We are the light of the world." Jesus didn't mean that we all of a sudden glow in the dark. He meant that when we go out into the world doing what Jesus tells us to do, people will see what we do and learn more about God. Jesus talked about salt and light so everyone can know how to go out and change the world. You and I can do that too, because Jesus taught us how to make a difference.
Wow, boys and girls, what an amazing video. And that really helped us learn this story about salt and light. Now, boys and girls, I want to point out something very cool. So salt and light are two things found in the environment, found out in nature, right? And they affect their environment simply by being exactly what they are, by being exactly what God created them to be. That means that's why you notice salt in food. And that's why you notice a flashlight in a dark room. Isn't that cool? All right, boys and girls, let's get to our Bible verse. Hi, boys and girls, and I'm here to do the Bible verse with you here today. So I have our Bible, and so we're going to do a special kind of Bible verse today. I'm gonna teach you how to do the Bible verse in sign language. I'm gonna do it a little bit slower so that you guys can follow along. Are you ready? All right, 1, 2, 3. So we're in John 13:15, and it says, "I did this as an example for you, so you should do as I have done for you." Good job, boys and girls. So I'm gonna teach you guys how to make a salt lamp, and you'll need a few things. So you'll need a bowl. It could be large or small. You'll need some lights. You could use leftover Christmas lights. I chose you beautiful fairy lights. And you'll need some salt. And I chose pink Himalayan salt because it's beautiful. So what you'll do first is you'll take your light and you'll put it at the bottom of the bowl. Let's see, just really put it in there. And this bowl looks especially pretty with those fairy lights. And now you'll just input all of your salt. Now, this reminds me of our lesson, boys and girls, because us Christians, we live our life a little bit differently, right? And even when the bad things like this bitter salt is piled on top of us, our light still shines. Wow, it's amazing. All right, boys and girls, we're almost done. You can put as much as you want in there. And look at that. Just like I said, boys and girls, the light still shines and it even illuminates all the bitter things in our life. So amazing. And if you make this, you'll remember this lesson forever and ever. Wow, boys and girls, this was so much fun. Thank you so much for doing this with me. I love learning how to do new things with you. Okay, we'll see you next week.